Hello, everybody. Julie Goodnight here again for another daily dose of your horsemanship homework. And this is another arena lesson starring Woodrow. He's Melissa's 2-year-old quarter horse gelding. He's been started under saddle, but he's still very immature. And he's our ideal candidate for working on ground manners. So we're going to just get started here on a new lesson for today, which is going to be learning boundaries while leading. And basically, we're talking about leading manners. And first, I want to remind you of the first two things we did. First and foremost, with Mr. Woodrow here, who's a very friendly, nosy, brave, curious, busy-minded, as you can see, horse. When he would like to be very close to me, you can see right now he's seriously thinking about coming closer to me, but I'm just going to remind him there's a boundary here and he should just remember it. And just on the, to be on the safe side, Woodrow, it's a very good idea for you to err on the side of being a little bit farther away from me, or to err on the side of being very cautious around me. So this is what I'm trying to teach him in the number one lesson, which is to observe my boundary, which is as far as I can reach around me. The boundary stick is quite handy for that because it easily defines the boundary in a way the horse can see and in a way that you can see and understand and reinforce. So Woodrow here is very sensitive, smart, quick learning horses. A lot of busy-minded horses are. And so he learned that boundary. It took very minimal reinforcement, me shushing him away from me before he started in a more mannerly way observing his boundaries. So I'm really proud of him right now because he's also doing a really good job on the second part of the ground manner lesson that we had yesterday, which is keep your feet still when I tell you to, and that means whenever I am facing you, keep your feet still. So he accidentally took a step there. He wasn't thinking about it very well, and so I gave him a high pressure correction. There was actually no physical pressure there, but the quick, sharp movement I made with the rope and my feet was plenty of pressure for him to take a step back, and so he did the right thing. And so I'm going to step him back up here into the sunlight. Good boy. And I'll ask him to woo, but I would like him to square himself up. Good boy. And then I loosen the rope. And so if you remember then, part two of our ground manners lesson was keep your nose in front of your chest and don't move your feet unless I tell you to. So whenever I'm facing you, that means don't move your feet, period. I will always be a good leader. I will always square you up first. I will always make sure you're standing in a comfortable place. That I'm being as clear as I can, but when I'm facing you, don't move a foot. So notice there's a great deal of distance between him and me. I'm trying to reinforce this boundary, number one. And number two, the farther away I have authority over the horse, the more authority I have. So see, just in stepping away from him just a little bit, he thought, oh, well, it must be okay for me to do whatever I want. And so I gave him a little scolding there. Reminded him, no, feet still. Okay, and so then part two of this manner lesson was keep your nose in front of your chest. We don't want to develop horses that bite. Good boy. So you hear that big sigh, also lowering of the head, the licking and chewing. All of these are signs of relaxation and understanding from the horse. And so we also established a boundary of, imagine two parallel lines coming out from the point of his shoulder. Whenever I am around you on the ground or in the saddle, keep your nose between those two lines. No looking around. Your only choice is to stay here with me and focus on me or focus on nothing. You don't get to look around at every little thing, even when the dog is photobombing, as she always does. So don't want to make a mistake on your feet there. Good. Now, he can move his nose up and down all he wants. Just no looking around. He can look around comfortably. He just can't cross that line of his shoulder. And whoops, there he's crossing the line. So I just give him one bump. And that one bump is enough to, one, bring his nose back within the boundaries, and two, make him not want to cross the line again. So as the horse learns, my corrections become smaller and smaller. You'll see that as he starts learning this boundary of where he can look around and where he cannot look around, he will start coming to the line and back before I have a chance to correct him or reinforce the boundary like that. And so these are all signs. Let's see what he does there. I would say he pushed the boundary there, but before I could get my hand down the rope to correct, he was back where he was supposed to be. So now he's just kind of testing me a little bit to see how much I'm going to reinforce the boundary. So at some point I'm going to give him another correction and he'll know. Okay, so as he starts understanding the rules, this horse is a boundary pusher, isn't he, Mel?
Yes, he is. Constantly testing the limits.
But you know what? See there? Yeah, I know what you're doing, Bogey. And you think you're smarter than me, don't you? And the sad truth is, horses like this are often smarter than the people who handle them. And they can get spoiled really easily. All horses are fast learning, all of them. Some are faster learning than others. And horses learn all things, good and bad, equally fast. And so horses like this can, learning bad habits when they're young would be just a tragedy. But he's a fun horse to work with, because there's a lot of this same traits of his temperament are really positive. He's engaged, he's brave, he's willing, he's interested, all those things. Now, I will not correct him for stepping away from me just then, because I stepped towards him. So actually, I think that was a really good sign that he's learned. I highly reinforce my boundaries. And so I'm just going to, he is doing such a stellar job. Before we get started on our lesson for today, I'm going to give him some praise. So I will change my body language here. I'm going to round my shoulders, angle them away, glance my eyes away, and I'll just come so close before I actually praise him and pet on him. I'm going to let him smell my hand. I have on gloves, which I always wear with horses, so they have a lot of gray smells on them. And when he's finished smelling, I'll just see if he wants me to touch his face. If not, I'm going to come over here and just pet him on the neck, tell him he's a good boy. I really keep your nose where it belongs. You don't get to put it on me. Okay, so interesting, because this is an interesting thing about horses. Horses are very location specific in what they learn. And he has learned that when I am in front of him, he cannot come towards me. But he has not learned that when I am on his side, he's not allowed to put his nose, turn his nose and put it on me. So let's just see if this lesson is needed. So, and it was the offside I was on just a minute ago, so I'm just going to correct his nose with the stick and just hold the stick up. Now, this is probably more because it's on his offside, would you say, Mel?
Probably, yeah.
So, you know, like a lot of horse owner, Mel's a busy person. She's mostly busy riding and taking care of my horses, and she doesn't ride and take care of her horses as much. And so he hasn't been handled a lot on the off side. And so when I came over here, first of all, he's like, "What are you doing?" And so he thought he ought to be able to put his nose on me. And I just, with the stick, I can just very easily reinforce the boundary and say, no, no matter where I go, you don't get to put your nose on me, and you certainly don't get to bring it towards me. So going back to my original plan, which was to just give him some praise, give him a moment. If I want to give my young horse, particularly one like this that's very busy-minded, kind of an intense horse, if I want to just give him a minute to relax, I'll step away from him, turn my back to him. Now, since he wants to crowd my space, I'm going to kind of keep one eye on him and make sure he doesn't come close to me. But I'm going to let him, give him a minute just to relax and not have to think and not have to worry about the pressure I'm going to put on him or worry about what I'm going to ask him to do. So just let him be a horse for a minute.
Eat the dirt.
Of course, like the taste of that chloride in the dirt. Funny how white-nosed horses like it better.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to go about our lesson for today then. Let's go back out. So he's been in here with his good buddy, Gus. Same age, same breeding, lived their whole lives together. So we're going to leave this door open here as I come work with Woodrow out in the driveway. And I'm kind of want to see how much of a distraction it's going to be for Woodrow if Gus is calling at him and worried about him. So Mel's going to walk alongside me now, and before I start, let me explain, because this can go really fast in the training, and I can train faster than I can explain. So what I want to teach Woodrow, remember, Ground manners are about making the horse safe and pleasant to handle, so that the horse is well cared for and safe and secure his whole life. And particularly important in young horses who are forming, learning things and forming opinions about people and their interactions with people that are going to last them the rest of their lives. So we want to make sure all of these things are properly taught at a young age. I call this kindergarten for horses. You don't go to kindergarten to learn how to do algebra. You go to kindergarten to learn how to sit at your desk, raise your hand when you want to talk, and walk in a single file line. And so we're going to go through kindergarten right now for leading manners. I call this Leadline leadership. One of my best-selling videos is on ground manners. Two of my best-selling videos are on ground manners. One is called Leadline Leadership. It's available streaming and as a DVD still. And of course, if you are in my interactive membership, you have assignments that include this information. Also, if you subscribe to our online training library, all of this information is there as well. So, kindergarten for horses, when it comes to leading, this is sort of an extension of a boundary lesson. So I want to teach him what the way I expect him to act when he's being led by me or anyone. I want to teach him the position I expect him to stay in. And he will learn that, because when he's in the wrong position, I'm going to let him know. I'm going to be very clear exactly where my boundaries are, which is that he's not allowed to get his nose in front of my lead hand. You'll see that the instant his nose goes in front of my lead hand, I'm going to snap the rope, stomp my feet, hiss and spit, and back him up until he learns he cannot cross that forward boundary. Another boundary it's important for the horse to learn in leading is what he does with his shoulder. It's very bad manners to put the head towards you or the shoulder towards you. So if he starts leaning on me or pushing on me with his left shoulder, I'm going to either use the tail of the rope. This is another reason why we use a long lead, so that we always have a pretty long tail to use in signaling the horse. And so I'll either use the tail of my rope behind me to establish my boundary with his shoulder, or I'll pick the stick up. Now, since he's wanting to kind of put his nose on me a lot, is the reason, and that initial thing of being too close to me, not being aware of my personal space, that's why I'm carrying the stick. I prefer not to have a stick when I'm doing lead line work, because hopefully you've already done this foundational work. So we'll see how it goes. If I feel like I don't need the stick. That was very good. You did an excellent job right there, Mr. Woodrow. Yes, I mean, he's looking at Mom going, see, I did it. Okay, nose in front of the chest. All right, so when I expect him to stand, I'm always facing him. I'm away from him. I got slack in the rope. So as I come over here into the leading position, already the horse is getting an indication that we're going to do something different. And so since he's been really careful to stay out of my space, I give a little warning with my... going to give him a little warning with the tail of my rope. Get your shoulder away from me. I'm going to go down this way. Wanting to come behind me, which is, by the way, where a horse wants to be. I'm just gonna doing, and that's what horses do naturally. They follow other horses. And so what I want to teach him now is that he needs to keep his shoulder. He needs to walk beside me, not behind me. And that's a hard thing to learn. His shoulder towards me. I'm going to take the tail of my rope behind me and move his shoulder away, and then go right back to leading. Now, the more I turn him away from me, the more shoulder control I'm getting. Thank you.
this out. This is really going against, number one, what he's used to, and number two, what comes naturally to him, which is to want to follow directly behind me. I get it. I get that it's confusing. But the only way I can teach him this rule of behavior, or any rule of behavior, is to try to explain it clearly, to reinforce the boundary consistently, and to sort of give the horse space to learn it. And so the reason why I stopped him just there to rub on him a little bit is because he made a real big effort to get out of my, to move his shoulder away from me when I asked. And I think he's kind of right on the verge of understanding that I'm asking for something different, and he needs to think about a little harder about what that thing is. Good boy. At least he's not getting in front of me yet. And good boy. Without Peter, he stepped away. Good boy. All right, that deserves another little praise. That's right. Good boy. Okay. All right, so as I suspected, he's just gonna even, so Gus is calling, whinnying to him, and doesn't matter, he's not allowed to turn his nose, so I had to go back and reinforce, that number two rule. Good, he wanted to move his nose and he thought better of it. Good boy. Trying real hard. This is a very, very willing horse, a very sweet horse. He's just got a lot going on up there. So I feel like he is doing pretty well, or he's really beginning to understand, oh, she's asking me to do this and to keep my shoulder away. It's hard for a horse to learn to the shoulder is always the hardest part of the horse to control, and that's true for the horse, and it's true for you. Whether you're riding or on the ground, it's the shoulder that is the most difficult to control. So by asking him to walk beside me in a position where he is right now, instead of directly behind me, is important for my safety, even though it goes against his natural grain. And so now that he's starting to get it, I'm going to just get my rope organized so I have enough tail here to reinforce the proper boundary. So I'm going to cue him to walk now, so I can just kind of look ahead, inhale, and then we'll walk. And I want him to learn to... Good boy! What a good boy! Going to give him some slack on the rope there. And I'm just going to stop. Let's get your nose over there. Good boy. So, as I suspected, he's really starting to connect the dots here. So always a good time to stop and praise, and then we can go right back at it. Because what's really important is the stop and praise and release of pressure. And then I can start right back again in 10 or 15 seconds. And then it's like a whole new training session. So we'll try that again. So I'll come into a very formal position here. I want him to learn to keep his nose over there. I'm gonna look forward, inhale and reach, and then step, rope goes tight. So he's gonna learn there to move off with me so the rope doesn't go tight. Now he's staying behind my hand, so get him getting in front of me, this wasn't a problem until right there. Good boy. All right, so we'll keep moving a little bit here.
good. Now, I'm happy with him keeping extra distance from me because that is way better than the alternative, and it shows me he's really putting a lot of thought into this. So I'm fine with this, a greater distance. We're gonna just turn the corner here. Come on, figure it out. Good boy, good boy. That shoulder over there, very nice. Very nice. Okay, so just gonna, he's doing so great that this lesson is almost over. So just one more thing we're gonna work on again is the stop and go cue. So watch how I cue with my body. When I get in the sun here, I'm gonna lift my shoulders. Good boy. I lift my shoulders, slow my feet, and then stop. And so it goes to show you that with one correction for him going in front of my hand a minute ago when I asked him to stop, he's already learned the stop cue. So we're gonna walk back towards the barn, and I might, and I'm just gonna reinforce what we've already learned today, which is keep your shoulder away from me, and I'll use the tail of my rope for that. Keep your nose off of me, and then stay behind my hand. So let's go this way. Move the shoulder, gotta move the nose first. On me, good boy. So we're gonna by habit he moved his shoulder towards me, but then he immediately took it off of me, so that was great. Shows me he's learning. Now he's about to get in my front of my hand, but when I simply wiggled my fingers, he thought better of it. So I'm gonna give him the cue to stop, and we'll see how he does. One more time. Good boy. Good boy. That was very good. That's your daily dose of horsemanship homework for today. If you're stuck at home, I want you to, number one, think about what you learned today in terms of teaching ground manners to horses. Number two, think about what ground manners your horse is lacking and you need to work on. And number three, what changes are you personally going to make in the way you handle horses that will make your horse a better equine citizen? If you are stuck at home with your horse, lucky you. And what I'd like you to do is work on these basic manners with your horse in just the way that I've done them here. Do it two or three, 4 days in a row, and let me know how it went the next time we do a Facebook Live. Thank you guys for joining me. I'm Julie Goodnight. You can find out this and everything you'd want to know about horses at my website, juliegoodnight.com.